So, by the way, here's a question for you. We can make it a quiz, but I'm not going to make it a quiz. What is the value of the game at p equals 0.4?
So I just plug it into those equations. And so negative 10 times 0.4 is like negative 4 plus 5 is 1. So I'm going to say 1.
Mm-hmm. So the value here is, in fact, 1 cent. And if you put it in the other equation, you'd get the same thing.
Yes, right, because they're equal there.
That's actually the answer to the entire kit and caboodle.
Where were the kittens?
If A chooses a mixed strategy where with probability 0.4, he chooses to be a holder, notice that it doesn't matter whether B is a resigner or B is a seer, you will end up here, and there will be a value of plus 1 penny to A.
On average.
The expected value is plus 1.
Neat.
Now, you might ask yourself, well, what if B decides to be a smarty pants and also do a mixed strategy? What do you think would happen in that case?
So, of course, it changes something, but it doesn't change the value of the game because if B is a resigner, A is getting 1 on average. If B is a seer, then A is getting 1 on average. And any convex combination of 1 and 1 is going to give us 1.
That's exactly right. So, in fact, if you think about it, if B tries to do a mixed strategy between these two lines, it's going to have to be for every single point between the two lines somewhere. The average is going to have to be somewhere in between there, no matter how you weight that average.
So it's like a bow tie is the space of possible payoffs.
Right. And since for any, let's say if B decided to pick some value such that it's in this region of the space and it's going to end up somewhere, say, between here, that's fine, or here, that's fine, or here, that's fine, or here, that's fine, or here, that's fine. More importantly, right here, it's going to have to be between the two lines, but those two lines cross. So no matter what mixed strategy B chooses, on average, we will end up here. So the value of this game is the expected value of this game, and it is plus 1 for A.
Now, hang on. So why is that? Why is it not? I mean, there's other values that could be obtained. There's a minus 5. There's a plus 5.
True.
Like, why is it plus 1?
Well, it's plus 1 here on average. The expected value of this game is plus 1.
So you say that the strategy for A is to choose 0.4. But why? Like, why is that, of all the different values, it's just because the lines intersect. I don't understand what makes that a good idea for A. Like, it's not like it gets any additional payoff for having things intersect.
Well, if A is going to choose a mixed strategy and B is going to choose a mixed strategy, this is the mixed strategy for A that guarantees an expected value of plus 1. Meanwhile, so imagine that this is the way you're going to set it up. So we've been kind of talking in general that A is going to choose a strategy, B is going to choose a strategy, then they're going to go. And that because we know everyone's rational, you already know which strategy B is going to pick, and B already knows which strategy A is going to pick, right? Because we've made this assumption about everyone's trying to maximize their own utility or their own reward. So in a mixed strategy, if you know you're going to go for a mixed strategy, you have exactly the same situation. B can figure out, well, what is it that A should choose? And A can figure out what is it B should choose. So notice that in this particular version of the game, the way it's set up, even if A announced beforehand to B, listen, I am going to choose to be a holder with probability 0.4. It doesn't matter what B chooses. The expected value is this. It's plus 1, right?
Yeah.
But imagine that A said, well, I'm going to choose to be a holder with probability 1. Well, then what should B do? B should choose to be a seer.
Right.
It's exactly the situation we were in before.
Okay, but here's the thing I'm having trouble wrapping my head around. So it's not special that it's an intersection. What's special maybe is it that, you know, if B is always – okay, so taking what you said before, that A is going to announce a strategy. So – for anything that A can announce, B is going to presumably do whatever's best for B.
Right.
Which is to minimize, right?
Mm-hmm.
So if you look at that triangle at the bottom, if you think about that as those lines, that V, upside down V shape. Yeah, exactly, that thing. If you think about that as being the payoff function for A as a function of the probability P that it chooses to hold.
Mm-hmm.
Then we've chosen the maximum.
Right.
Right? We're trying to find the probability for which A gets the highest expected value, and that it's at that peak there.
Mm-hmm. But notice something, Michael. For any case where the two lines cross, you're going to have a function of this form.
Ah, well, let's be sure of that, because I was thinking that was not true. Because basically, in this case, we have a line of positive slope and a line of negative slope. right? So what if we can have an intersection between two lines of negative slope?
So again, by doing the same exercise you were doing before, where you draw the, you sort of take the minimum of the two lines at all points.
Yeah.
You'll end up with this. Where do you pick it then?
The far left, P equals zero.
Yeah.
But not the intersection in particular.
No, that's true.
Okay. All right. I wasn't quite getting that. But so the intersection is special because in some cases that is where the max is. It can I guess the max can only be in those three places, right? It could be far left, far right, or the intersection. There's no other way to have a maximum of lines.
Right. And by the way, there's another case like this where they never actually cross.
Mm.
Or like this where they never actually cross.
Got it.
Right. But in either case, right, it's always going to be those three points. It's going to be the extreme or where they cross. If they happen to never cross, then that point goes away. And so you just pick the maximum. So what you could, so in fact, if you wanted to think of an algorithm to choose the right thing to do for A, you basically plot the lines. You take the min at every point and you find the maximum point.
Oh, I see. So you could just kind of discretize it almost.
Yeah, and you're done. Seem reasonable?
Well, discretizing seems problematic, but like I get that we're trying to find the probability so that we maximize.
Right.
Oh, wait, we maximize the minimum of the two other things. Mm-hmm. So it's like maxi min again.
Yeah, except here, so in fact, it is exactly minimax or maxi min, except, well, I guess if you're thinking it from A's point of view, it's minimax or maxi min, but in this case, there's this other parameter, which is the probability, which is how you determine how you're doing the minimax.
Got it. Right. In this bigger space, it's minimax. I see. Yeah. That makes sense. What about, but why is A the one who needs to be random? Why isn't B the one who needs to be random?
It's, you end up in the same place. Because again, remember, you're doing this kind of optimal notion where underneath all of that is this belief that both people are going to be rational. So the only reason to do this, to take the, you know, maximum minimum, is if you believe that B is always going to try to minimize what you do. But B's in exactly the same situation, right? From B's point of view, that's what's happening.
Huh. It's the same equations?
Yeah, it gets turned around. That's actually an interesting exercise. Maybe that's a nice homework assignment.
Okay.
So does that all make sense to you? Now that
it
we've said it 15
times.
Looks
a little green and scribbly, but yeah, sure. That's cool.
That's how you know when you're done, Michael, when it's all green and scribbly.
Does this generalize to more than two options? It seems like it's going to get messy fast.
Yes, it does. It generalizes to more than two options. Effectively, now you're just doing a max over n things instead of two things.
And you have to search for, there's possibly way more intersections to worry about.
Yeah, but all you care about is the minimum. Think of it as you're always drawing the minimum function.